Hi everyone, in this video I am going to discuss photolithography. It is one of the important steps in fabrication of the MOSFETs. So photolithography, the term means photo, light, litho, stone, graphy, writing. So photolithography means the usage of light for writing the patterns. So this is a process of transferring the patterns from the mask to the wafers. So what is the role of lithos here? What is the role of stone here? Yes, it is a term used from some years where people used to use the stones for carving, for engraving some pattern on the stone, and using that structure they can reproduce the same on any number of objects. It's similar to the stamp pad, which is made once, and whenever we use the ink we can take the stamp pad any number of times, we can reproduce. So in the same way, when the geometric pattern is prepared, we can reproduce that onto the wafers any number of times. Whenever we use the light for that purpose, we call that as photolithography. So photolithography is art of writing using the light source. So we can see here in this picture, photolithography is taking place with a very clean environment, because some contamination occurred to the mask or to the wafer is going to degrade the performance of the further steps. So lot of care should be taken, and this can be the different several layers shown here. So photolithography is used to selectively process the layers where the 2D mask geometry is copied on the surface. So the definition of photolithography is the process of transferring geometric shapes on a mask to the surface of a silicon wafer. So these are the steps in the photolithography. So first of all, silicon substrate is taken, on which oxidation is done, silicon dioxide is deposited, on which photoresist coating is done. So photoresist is a viscous liquid polymer which is applied to the top surface of oxidized wafer. So how it is applied? The application typically occurs by dropping or spraying a small volume of photoresist onto a rapidly rotating wafer. So it's like of ink filler type of object is used for dropping the viscous liquid, and uniformly it is rotated. So due to that, we are able to form a thin film on the surface. So due to the spinning, the coated wafer is applied. Then so this is the photoresist coating. Then on to that, UV light is made to pass through the mask. Here mask is used. Mask contains the geometrical pattern. And this photoresist material is nothing but radiative sensitive material, radiation sensitive polymer. So radiation sensitive means this is sensitive to the light. Whenever light falls, the properties of the material change. So some portion of the mask, this gets soluble, and some portion becomes hardened. So we can see whenever light is made to fall, here we are having the mask, and some portions are transparent, some portions are opaque. So depending on the type of photoresist material, we are able to have the difference in the structure. Like suppose we are using the positive photoresist. In the positive photoresist, whenever light ray is made to fall through the mask, whenever light is falling through the mask, then that portion whichever is allowing the light to fall through it, that becomes softened, soluble. The material becomes soluble. Similarly, coming to the negative photoresist, whichever is exposed to the light, that portion becomes polymerized, that portion becomes hardened. The portion which is covered from the light, that portion becomes softened. So this is difference between positive photoresist and negative photoresist, but whatever it may be, photoresist is sensitive to the light. So here in this example, it is shown negative photoresist. That means whenever light is made to fall through it, then the portions which is exposed to the light becomes hardened. The portion which is covered, that becomes here we can see soluble. So whichever is covered, that is soluble. Whichever is allowing the light, that becomes polymerized. So it is exactly complement in terms of the positive photoresist. So why we are doing this? In order to open a window here, in order to get the pattern whichever is there on the mask that we want to copy onto the wafer. So here this is done and we are able to open a window. Then we need to remove the unwanted oxide, unwanted photoresist once the window is opened. So next steps are those. So in the next steps here, whatever oxide is there, that oxide we need to remove. So that is etched. Etching is removal. Then this hardened photoresist is also not needed actually. We want only this window. So for that excess photoresist which we don't require, that also should be removed. So these are all the steps taking place. So taking substrate on the deposition of oxide, deposition of photoresist, applying the UV light through the mask and copying the pattern, removing the excess photoresist after removing the excess oxide layer. So these are the basic steps of the lithography. First step is surface preparation. So surface preparation means the heating the wafer initially to a temperature sufficient to drive off any moisture that is present on the wafer surface. And the wafers that have been in storage must be chemically heated, cleaned to remove the contamination. Next, photoresist application we already discussed, like using ink filler type of object to spray the photoresist material and spin. And once it is spinned, the coating wafer is to be, coated wafer is to be soft baked. So what is this soft baking? So soft baking is, it is mainly used to improve the adhesion to the underlying substrate. And it is mainly used to drive off some solvents from the photoresist, and adhesion will be improved due to the pre-baking. It is also called as pre-baking. Next, aligning and exposing. Aligning and exposing is using the appropriate mask and making the UV light to fall through it. Next, developing. Developing is, it is like developing a photo film. So we need to use a developer solution, which is a mixture of deionized water and potassium hydroxide. So the wafer is dipped onto the developer solution so that the exposed resist areas on the substrate dissolve in the developer solution, and this is called as developing. It is similar to developing the films. Next, baking, hard baking. So we need to do one more time baking to typically 120 to 180 degrees. This hard baking solidifies the remaining photoresist. So the remaining photoresist will become hardened. So to make it durable for further processes, future ion implantation, like that, some other process will be there. To make it durable, we'll do the hard baking. Next, etching. Etching is removing the unwanted material. It can be dry etching or wet etching. So, depending on the application, we'll be choosing the one. Next, photoresist. Stripping. So, stripping means removal of the photoresist. So, finally, inspecting. If we inspect finally, we need to have a very good output. Whatever we are expecting, that we need. So, these are all the steps of photolithography. So, these are all the steps. So, we can see the light falling and pattern is writing on the wafer, and we can see multiple layers will be present. So, using the light source through the mask, whenever it is exposed, we are able to have the pattern which is copied onto the wafer from the mask. So, ultimately, photolithography is copying the pattern, geometrical patterns from mask to the wafers. So, different types of photolithographies are present, like exposure systems are present, contact printing, proximity printing, projection printing. So, contact printing is bringing the mask and the wafer contact. We can see mask and wafer both are brought to contact, so which increases the resolution, sometimes we may have some unacceptable defect densities. So, because whenever we are bringing both to contact, sometimes we may have damage caused, and it may result to the low yields. So, practically, there will be a lot of problems due to this contact lithography. Now, practical problems such as mask may damage, and we may have some unusual consequences, and due to which we can have less yield. But advantage is it will have very high resolution. Next, proximity printing. In proximity printing, it is similar to the contact photolithography, except that there is a small gap, some small gap of some microns will be present, some small gap we can see. Here both are brought directly to the contact. Mask and wafer are directly in contact. In contact printing, here small gap is present. So, except that there will not be any difference. So, due to that, some resolution, poor resolution will be there when compared to the contact printing. Contact printing is having very high resolution. Coming to the projection printing. Projection printing is some distance is maintained. By far, the most common method of exposure is projection printing. Projection lithography derives its name from the fact that an image of the mask is projected onto the wafer. So, image of the mask is projected onto the wafer. Like a projector, we are going to project the image of the mask onto the wafer. So, each one has its own advantages and disadvantages. It provides high resolution and low defect densities, and it is mostly used nowadays. So, ultimately, photolithography is a process which is very much useful, and it is done not once or twice, some 20 to 30 times in a fabrication process it is done. Whenever we want to open some windows for doping or further fabrication process, we use the lithography technique. If we use light, it is called photolithography. If we use ion beam, it is called ion beam lithography. If we use electron beam, it is electron beam lithography. Like that, there are different ways of lithography. Ultimately, it is used to transfer the patterns from mask to the wafers. Thank you, one and all.